It can take up to 3 years for a sea lion to learn how to balance a ball on its nose, and the whiskers are the key to making it all happen. Their whiskers have a specialised network of muscles which are highly sensitive to touch. Research in 2014 by Alex Milne and Robin Grant has shown that their whisker movements respond rapidly and can mirror the movement of the ball.
It's something that we have to teach and train the sea lions to do. It can take a sea lion anything from well over a year, if not 2 or 3 years, to learn how to do this. And that's every single day, at least 3 to 4 times a day, every day before they learn how to do this with the ball on the nose. The secret and the skill is using the whiskers around their nose, which are very, very sensitive to any touch or movement, and they can feel which way the ball's moving, which way it's rolling, using those long, sensitive whiskers. So if the water's too dark, too murky, or if a sea lion in the wild happens to lose use of his eyesight, they can still survive relying on those whiskers to help them find fish. And a very similar method is used when balancing the ball. We start to teach and train the sea lions to do this at about Ruby's age, about 2 or 3 years old, because they're too little to hold such a large ball on those until they're about this sort of size. Oh, you want to try? She's learning this at the moment. We're teaching her how to do this, but she's doing very, very well. Okay, you've done okay, haven't you? You want to do more? Okay. But as I say, she's learning to do this. I thought the camera might put her off. But as you can see, she's only doing it just for a few seconds. When she does it for a few seconds, that's it, the whiskers are nice and high. Well done, Ruby. And then she gets a piece of fish. And that just point and proof case is that they enjoy doing these behaviours. I didn't ask her to do that. They enjoy doing these behaviours. It's very, very important that we keep that rapport with the sea lion. They get used to our tone of voice, our body language, and of course the way that we move, just as we do with them. And of course, the more we work with them, the better they are. And of course, the more consistent we can be with the training, which in turn allows us to be very, very good with their welfare and upkeep. Let Gina have a go. Oh, we're going to pass it to Gina. So you pass it to your big sister. There we go. Gina can also do this. She lets the whiskers do the work. But again, just like with the hoop catching, we like to make it more interesting and more challenging by asking them to pass the ball between themselves, of course, pass it back to me. Well done, you two. Very, very good. But also, we can then ask them to walk with the ball and swim with the ball, which does require extra training.